Yeah.
Cool. So do we want to discuss the gRPC?
Yeah.
So I think there are two approaches to solve the problem that's mentioned in the issue.
Well, can you just, for everyone on the call, can you provide a recap of the actual problem?
Yeah, sure. So so currently gRPC has a certain mapping of the requested, the response status and the actual status returned from Envoy, which is mentioned in the issue. But there is a particular status which is during a rate limit, and that is not mapped correctly on the Envoy's end. So the issue is asking for a solution, maybe through config, that would map a particular status in two different status within Envoy. So my suggestion was to have a generic map that would like map a whole bunch of statuses into something else. But do we want to go that way, or do we want
flexible? Like, I mean, I don't know if many people are going to want this. Can't we just fix this in the rate limit service? Have that actually apply the fix up?
I'm sorry, I didn't catch that.
Can't the rate limit service just apply the fix up itself if this is an issue with rate interaction of rate limits in gRPC?
I think we can do that. But my question is whether we want a generic solution that would cover all the different possibilities.
Like, what other possibilities are there? If there's like three or four different things that need remapping, yeah, I agree totally. We should have something like that. But if it's really just an issue here with the specific interaction of gRPC and rate limits.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So maybe then we'll stick to just a single status.
Yeah, but if someone wants to speak up and suggest otherwise, all he has.
Okay, thanks.
Did we get gRPC savvy people weighing in on here? Yeah, good, Lizon's on there. Yeah. I will take Lizon as a generic gRPC.
Wow, he's no longer with, yeah.
No, I know. But as someone who cares about gRPC, he's gonna think about like Istio, whether or not it's still there. Cool. Okay.
Yeah. I think that's so.
And I think that may be it, unless anyone has other things we're gonna talk about.
Speak up.
Going once, going twice.
Do you want to talk about the V1 deprecation? Share the progress in that API deprecation.
Well, so I feel like we don't have a totally solid status on that. So we killed off the V1 command line, and that is thoroughly done. Something like 8 out of 9 of the deprecated V1 protofields have also been marked deprecated. And we could arguably remove them, except some of them probably shouldn't have been marked as deprecated because we have deprecated and not ready yet, roughly, for the TCP proxy work. So I do think that by policy, we probably shouldn't have allowed that field to be marked deprecated until we had the solution for it.
That's probably true, yeah.
So slap on the wrist for limitators.
I don't know, because like you want to discourage the use of it, right, like for any further use. So there is that. It hasn't been deprecated in that we're actually ready to retire it, but you know, it's deprecated but not yet ready thing. Yeah, like
Google Classic.
We still didn't want anyone like adding new fields there or doing things. So like calling it deprecated certainly made sense.
That's fair. Yeah. No, but we explicitly called out in the release notes for the last release that the deprecated V1 fields were officially deprecated.
Okay.
I think either we could have called them out individually and said all of them are except for the ETC proxy one or not. But yeah, I was on the fence on to whether or not we should get rid of the deprecated V1 proto fields that we don't believe are problematic. I'd started a PR to remove one of them, and I was like, maybe we should move them all together, and I don't know if anyone has opinions on that.
No, I think we can knock them off one by one. Like, yeah, we don't care about...
Okay, yeah. I'd started on it, and I'm like, you know what? I've done so many reversions on deprecated V1 PRs lately, I didn't want to deal with it. I'll pick it back up and start knocking them off.
Let's take us directionally where we want to be.
And I'll leave the TC proxy one specifically until the Istio folks are happy with functional compatibility.
Yeah, sounds good.
Cool. And then other than that, I think that's it for this release for V1 turndown stuff. I think next release will remove the old style REST API.
Yes. So for anyone who hasn't got the memo yet, V1 REST APIs in Envoy are not long for this world. They will be gone. It'll be a hard turn off.
So given that no one complained about the command line, I wonder if anyone actually cares, but hopefully not, because it'd be great if no one's upset. Yeah. I don't mind leaving the code in the code base for another 3 months. I just want to not cause people unexpected pain. So
yeah,
cool. And I should do a deprecation notice for that.
Yeah.
I'll go do that now. Okay. See you guys in 2 weeks.
Thanks.